For 25 years, Dozier Memorials has been proud to serve the community and to offer quality memorials built to last. Dozier Memorials offers bronze, granite, and marble memorials that will honor and preserve your memories forever, while providing you the highest standard of service and assistance. Dozier Memorials can help you plan before your time of need, assist you in financing your memorial, and installation is provided as well. Call today. Dozier Memorials, for 25 years, building memorials to last.
Hi, I'm Barbara Wilson of Wilson's Fine Furniture, and I'd love to show you some of the seasonal merchandise we have on our floor right now, including a wide variety of living room and bedroom suites. We are offering a 10% discount to new and paid out accounts. We want you to stop in and see our varied line of furniture and appliances, and we haven't forgot you senior citizens either. For a limited time, we are offering all senior citizens 15% discount. I'll see you at Wilson's Fine Furniture, Main Street in Manchester.
Getting this family together is like herding cats.
Simplifying things for families is a priority here at Grange Insurance. We offer a variety of policies through Grange independent agents.
He showed us the advantages of having all our policies with Grange.
If you have one policy through Grange, ask your agent.
Are we there yet?
I think you'll find that you're just getting started.
Let Patty Sue or Marcia review your insurance needs today at J. Smith Lanier & Company.
Your partner in protection.
846-2148.
It's hard to believe what some people will do to avoid the embarrassment of picking up a bounced check. That's why Bank of Upson and Meriwether Bank and Trust offer no bounce advantage with limits up to $2,000. Because we all run a little short now and then. No bounce advantage from Bank of Upson and Meriwether Bank and Trust.
Done, and I'm your host for School Daze. Thanks for joining us today. It's cold outside, so get yourself a cup of coffee or some hot chocolate and sit down and watch the interview that we're going to do with Kovatny Barber, Manchester High School's, one of Manchester High School star basketball players who has signed on with Auburn. So stay with us. We'll be right back. For almost 60 years, F&M Bank and Trust Company has offered the citizens of this area full-service banking. Customers know they can depend on complete, confidential financial service, whether they visit our main office downtown or the Town and Country branch office on Warm Springs Highway. Today, F&M Bank is your only hometown bank. This means your money stays here, not only working for you, but for our community as well. We're always glad to be of service and are happy to call this fine community our home. F&M Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender. I'm honored to have today as my guest Kovatny Barber, Vot as he's known around here, and Vot's one of our seniors here at Manchester High School. Among other things, he is probably one of the biggest star athletes that we've had in a while. And you see, he doesn't have a halo around his head, and he's not gloating. And this is the attitude Vot has had all along, and we've had lots of compliments on how Vot has handled his popularity and celebrity status and so forth. So that's very admirable, Vot. I'm glad to see you have on blue and white today, Manchester colors.
Yes, ma'am.
I have on orange, Auburn colors, so we're ready to roll here. Vot, how long have you played basketball?
Yes, it's all like 5 or 6.
So it's always been a part of your life.
Yes, ma'am.
Did you play on the middle school team?
Yes, ma'am.
And then when you came to high school, you were ready to play?
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me about your record, any records that you've set while you're here, or statistics, or anything you want to tell me about.
I'm not sure about all the records, because like my 9th, 10th grade, they ain't like keep the book like right, so I don't really know like how many records I own broke with or how many I have. So.
How many points do you generally score in a game?
I average like 21, I think.
That's good. Mm. That's great. What position do you play?
Center.
Center, okay. What's the largest number of points, greatest number of points you've scored in one game?
27.
Good. That's good. All right. Now, we need to talk about more than just basketball, don't we?
Yes, ma'am.
All right. How's it going being a senior here at Manchester this year?
It's going real well so far.
What's your toughest class?
Some of Eubank right now.
Everybody says that. Ms. Eubank's English class, and a lot of folks out there will agree with you. And she's fair, isn't she?
Yeah, ma'am.
She's tough, but she's fair. She really is. Now, when you graduate from Manchester in May of this year, what are your plans?
Go to Auburn, play basketball.
Right. And you've already signed with Auburn, haven't you?
Yes, ma'am.
You signed back around Thanksgiving?
November 10th.
November 10th.
Mm-hmm.
What was it like that day, knowing that you were signing the most important document in your life, short of a marriage license?
I don't know how I felt, to tell the truth.
It felt
good, though.
Excited?
Yeah, ma'am.
Good. What do your parents say about you going to Auburn?
They're real happy with my decision. Because it's close to home where they can come see me play and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of like going all the way off where they can come see most of my games or whatever.
Was that part of the reason you chose Auburn?
Yeah,
to include parents? That's good. That's very admirable. Tell me some of the schools that have offered you a position on their team.
Kentucky, Georgia, Georgia Tech, Florida State, Tennessee, Alabama, and there's a few more though.
Clemson.
Yeah, Clemson. Mm-hmm.
And coaches from several of those schools have actually been here to Manchester High School to visit with you. Probably the most memorable one was Tubby Smith from Kentucky.
Yeah.
He actually came and ate in our cafeteria, sat with you at lunch for a little while, and then sat with our teachers at the faculty table. I think Beverly Wadsworth said he sat with her for a little while. So you brought a little bit of glitter to Manchester High School. I guess we could even say a little bling there, because for Tubby Smith to come eat in our cafeteria, that's something now, I'm telling you. So we thank you for that.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, it doesn't take much to get us around here excited about something, and Tubby Smith got us excited. Did other coaches come and visit you during the school day?
Yes, coaches from UAB, University of Alabama, Birmingham, Auburn coaches, Tennessee, and Florida State coaches. I think that's it.
Did they really bug you about signing with them? They put the pressure on.
Mm-hmm.
Is that right? And so how long did it take you to make your decision?
It took me a while, Carl. It was so many colleges, and I just had to just think about where I wanted to go. So I just had to sit down for a while and just think for a long time.
And did you talk to your parents about it? Did they give you a lot of input?
Yeah, ma'am.
Good. All right. I know they're proud that you're going to Auburn.
Yeah.
All right, so what else do you still have to do before you're ready to leave us for Auburn?
I got to make an 840 on my SAT. Right now I'm at a 760. I got to make an 840, then I'll be eligible.
All right, and you're in an SAT prep class here.
Yes,
with
ma'am.
Ms. Shelton and Ms. Hall.
Mm-hmm.
So do you feel like you're going to do better when you take it next year?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. When will you take the SAT?
I took it this past Saturday.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. How'd you feel about it once you got
through? I think I did good.
Well, good. Mm-hmm. And there's still several opportunities before you leave.
Yeah.
Before you graduate to get that good SAT score. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, we're going to take a little break here, and we'll be right back.
It's time for Channel 10's Valentine Search 2005. Hi, I'm Brian Gibson. And Channel 10 wants you to write us a letter, one page or less, telling us why you feel your parents or a married couple in our area deserve to be our Valentine Couple 2005. Please include your name, the names of the couple, your phone number and theirs, and return address for both. Once we have all the letters at the end of the day, February 10th, 2005, the staff of Channel 10 will then select the most deserving couple and will be announced on Valentine's Day, February the 14th. The prize is valued at over $500. That includes two-night stay at the beautiful Callaway Inn, dinner for two at Magic City Grill, one dozen roses, balloons, and teddy bear from Dee Dee's Flowers, $100 gift certificate from Taylor Foster Gifts, $50 gift certificate from Nana's Porch, and a massage by Patty for both him and her. That couple you're thinking of could have a Valentine to remember. So act now and write us today. You can bring your letter to the studios of Channel 10 or mail it to us at 129 West Main Street, Manchester, Georgia, 31816. Again, deadline to enter is February 10th, 2005. It's Channel 10's Valentine Search 2005.
We're back, and notice I wore my Auburn bracelet today, my blue and orange, and my tiger face, and dug out my orange Auburn shirt, and Vot's wearing Manchester blue, so I think we mentioned that earlier, but deep at heart, I'm an Auburn fan, Vot. I have altogether about 20 first cousins on both sides of the family, and every one of them that went to college went to Auburn, except me. And so I'm sending you in my place. Would that be all right?
Yes, ma'am.
I don't think we look anything alike, but you can feel my spot over there. So I do love Auburn. It's an important part of my family, and I just really like Auburn. Some of my best friends went there, and I have a special place in my heart for Auburn, so I might be over there and watch you play. Vot, tell me what has kept you centered. You just seem so down to earth. I've never seen you misbehave. I've seen you, and I'm sure you did, and I just missed it. Maybe one time. But you seem so centered, so well-behaved. What keeps you so centered, Vot, so self-disciplined?
My parents, they stay on me about staying out of trouble and stuff and just being who I am. Don't let all this stuff, like, go to my head or whatever.
That's great. It would be real easy for them to build you up and give you the big head, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And tell us who your parents are.
Cynthia Barnes and John Barber.
And I know they are very, very proud of you.
Yes, ma'am.
And I didn't realize until earlier this week when I read an article in this magazine that Shamika's your sister.
Yes, ma'am.
Is Verona Lisa your sister?
No, this is my first cousin.
First cousin, mm-hmm. Okay. And I talked to Shamika, and she's very bright, and there's a good story in here, so this will be a good time to mention this now. Vot is the cover story of this month's school sports, which is all about, you hold it, Vot. There you go. There's an excellent article in here. Coach Noble gave me this one. Coach Noble is the head basketball coach here. And there's a good story in there. Vot said he never noticed growing up that his sister did lots of chores around the house. And then when she graduated from high school and left, and where'd she go to school?
She went to junior college. I think Southern Union.
She went to Southern Union. And all of a sudden, all the household chores fell to him. And he said he ended up doing a lot more than Shamika ever did.
Yeah.
They just added to the list, huh? Mm-hmm. All right. What was it like doing the interview for this story?
At first, I couldn't believe I was doing it because I just couldn't believe it, really. But it was all right. I was nervous at first, but.
Uh-huh. Did they take the pictures in our gym?
Yes, ma'am.
Excellent pictures.
Yeah.
How tall are you, Vot?
6'8".
6'8". I wish I was 6'8", and then I wouldn't be overweight. But, you know, I'm weight challenged, so. Okay. Were you always the tallest kid in the class?
Yeah.
And that's good. That makes you head and shoulders above everybody else. Well, do you feel that you have a mission or a burden on you because you've been recognized for your basketball talents?
I do. Sometimes, like, I feel like I have to prove myself to a lot of people, but I don't. So, mm-hmm. Not really.
All right. Do you feel like younger people look up to you to sort of set the way for them?
Yeah, ma'am.
All right. And so you kind of have to walk a straight line for them, don't
mm-hmm.
you? Set a good example. But let's think back to your basketball games. Do you have a favorite game or most memorable game?
We went to the Final Four last year. Like, they're the farthest we had ever won, like, I think, like, 10 years, I think.
That's great. And you made it how far?
To the Final Four, like, the semifinal.
That's right.
The game for the championship.
And this was in Macon?
Yes, ma'am.
At the Coliseum. That's an awesome place.
Mm-hmm.
That's where our girls won their state championship.
Yeah.
That's a wonderful place. If there was one game you could play over or redo, which would it be?
That game we lost.
Is that right? Do you remember the score?
I think we lost by like 15.
Bless your heart. But you'd like to do that one over,
mm-hmm.
huh? Will we make it that far this year?
Yeah, we're going to win it all this year.
Great. It'd be nice to graduate from here sporting that state championship ring, wouldn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
I think that means so much to so many players, absolutely. Well, anything you want to say about Coach Noble or any of your coaches that you've had?
All of my coaches, like, they taught me a lot of stuff. Coach Nova, he just really taught me about, like, not being regular like other people. Because, like, when he first came, he told me I was going to be a D1 player. But, like he said, I ain't just really believe him.
D1 being Division I college.
Yeah, and, like, he was telling me, like, don't be average like the other player. Just I have to be different so, like, I can just do other stuff besides just being regular or whatever. So.
And that inspired you?
Yeah.
Yes. Any other coaches you'd like to mention or give credit to?
Coach Cotton.
Coach Robert Cotton, who was here several years ago. What did you learn from Coach Cotton?
How to play defense.
He taught you how to play defense. Mm-hmm. Has he been back to see you play?
No, I haven't seen.
Is that right? I know he thinks about you, I'm sure.
Yeah, he calls sometimes.
Good. Mm-hmm. Maybe he'll show up in Macon to watch you play.
I hope so.
And I'm sure he'll show up at the Auburn games because, you know, he's an Alabama man himself. Yeah. And certainly an Auburn fan. Okay. What is your biggest challenge right now, Bot?
Just to make it Auburn, just graduate. Graduate from Auburn. Mm-hmm. Hopefully I make it to the NBA, I hope.
That would be so wonderful.
Mm.
And will you wave to us sometimes when you get to the NBA?
Yeah.
Okay, good. And come back and visit and eat lunch with us and sign autographs.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. And be on my show again. All right, Bot. Well, I need for you to autograph this for me because, you know, this is going to be one of my prized possessions.
All right.
So even though I didn't teach you, I won't make you write on there to the most wonderful teacher in the whole wide world, stuff like that. And if you will, put a date on it. And I would cherish this one. You know, Bot was in another magazine earlier in the year. You were not on the cover, but you were sort of in a featured section, and that was it?
Slam Magazine.
Slam Magazine. And they did a good article on it in there. But this one is just excellent. So if somebody would want a copy of this, I guess they could just get in touch with Coach Noble or let me see if this has a website, and I don't know that it does.
It's schoolsport.com.
Good. All right. So that's schoolsports.com, and it says the cover price is $350. Mm-hmm. It's the January-February 2005 issue. All right. What do you plan to major in while you're at Auburn?
I'm thinking about business management.
Good. Mm-hmm. That's good. Well, if there's anything I can do to help you, let me know. Don't call on me for help with math because I'll mess you up. But I hope you'll remember all of us because we're expecting great things of you. Now, this says that your nickname is The Beast. Is that what you're called? Or did they give you that name?
They just gave me that.
Do you have a nickname around here other than just Bot?
Well, V.O., that's what everybody calls me.
V.O., okay. Mm. So whatever we hear about you and from you, we know it's going to be good.
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have anything you'd like to say to folks out there before we close?
I was just trying to get this issue of this magazine and just support the Blue Devils.
Good.
Now on up.
And so you're definitely a team man. You don't play for yourself.
No.
One thing I like you said in here that your mama told you a long time ago about playing basketball, what was that?
Don't play for the crowd. Just play for the team.
And that's good. And I think this helped you stay focused.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. How many more games do we have this season?
We got two more regular season games. We got a game Friday against Callaway next Friday. And the Saturday after that, we go to Greenville.
All right, so those are always going to be good games. The game with Booker T. Washington was canceled.
Yeah.
What was the reason for that?
I'm not sure.
Booker T. Washington canceled, though. We did. Okay. And what's our record so far?
I think we're like 16-2, I think.
Good enough. Mm-hmm. That's wonderful. When do the playoffs start?
I'm not sure. I think a week after the last game.
So it's not part to be in February.
Mm-hmm.
And when is the state final?
It's like in March.
I can't wait. I'm excited. Oh, do you lie awake at night thinking about it?
Mm-hmm.
Good. All right, Bot. Thank you so much for being on my show today. I wish you all the luck in the world, and don't forget about us.
No.
Keep that head on straight, darling.
All right.
We love you. Okay. We'll be back. Stay with us.
What more can be said? The choice is clear. Fast service, free delivery, fair prices, Courtly Drugs. Beckham's Home Healthcare is proud to supply the products and services you need to care for the ones you love. Beckham's offers a selection of durable medical equipment such as oxygen tanks, respiratory medication, lift chairs, diabetic shoes, diabetic supplies, prosthetics and orthotics. We're also your local supplier for mastectomy fittings. Beckham's has free delivery and great local customer service 24/7. And if we don't have it in stock today, we can have it tomorrow at Beckham's Home Healthcare, Main Street in Manchester.
Generations Coffee House. Fresh gourmet coffee served in a comfortable atmosphere, perfect for business and family. Have breakfast with us, like bacon, egg, and cheese croissants. cinnamon rolls, bagels, or a wide variety of pastry items. Ask about our fantastic half and half lunch specials served daily. And enjoy the richness of Generations House Blend coffees and teas in our house or yours. Call in, dine in today on Main Street in Manchester. Generations Coffee House, not your average cup of joe. At Flint River Technical College, we help you get in, get out, and get ahead. Whether you want to start or continue your education, Flint River Tech has over 50 degree, diploma, and certificate programs. Choose from business, health, industry, and public service technologies. Flexible schedules, online classes, and financial aid make education available for everyone. Flint River Technical College in Thomaston. Call today to get in, get out, and get ahead.
I have with me, and this was not planned, and I came in the gym, and here she is, Courtney Favors, who is our art teacher here at Manchester High School. She graduated in 98 with my Tyler Dunn. And Courtney played for the MHS Lady Angels the year we won state. So I think since we're doing a story on Bach, Courtney, it's just appropriate to have you on here. What's your biggest memory of winning that night?
That you and Miss Bonner and another one of the
Gail Jones
and Gail came in the locker room and was so excited. I think you guys were more excited than we were.
Oh, thank you. I was just delirious. It was so wonderful that y'all had won, and that was in 96, and we were so proud of y'all because it had been so. Was that the first state championship Manchester ever won? And y'all just played your hearts out and looked cute while you were doing it, and we were really excited. That was a fun night. It really was. So, and you were called JoJo, and still are. How do you like teaching here?
It started off rocky, but I love it now.
Good. You're going to come back next year?
I sure am.
Good. We love having our alumni come back and teach with us. Thanks, JoJo. I appreciate your time.
You're welcome.
I have with me Coach Curtis Noble, who is the head coach of the Manchester boys basketball team. Coach Noble, I thank you for being with me on such short notice.
Well, I'm so glad to be here today.
Thank you. I interviewed Courtney Barber, and of course he's one of your players, and just all kind of accolades go to Courtney. So give us your thoughts on him and your how you feel about his playing.
When I first met Courtney last year coming over to Manchester High School, I saw a young man that has great potential. Courtney is a well-mannered kid,
yes,
and on the basketball court, he turns into what they say in the magazine now as a beast, which is good because then he's able to show his talent and his ability out there on the court.
Exactly, and it's good that he saves the beast for the court and, like you say, still remains so mannerable off the court. He's a very quiet, seems like really centered young man with his head on straight.
Yes, and we're looking for great things out of Courtney. Courtney is a kid that can go to the next level. When I say the next level, I'm talking about to Division I basketball and do well in that.
And we can say we were there.
Yes, we're extremely proud to be a part of all of this.
That's right. And we have a lot of talent on the team, and Courtney's not the only star that you have. They really play as a team, don't they?
Yes, and I'm really proud of all of the guys on the team. We have some more standouts. We're getting Antavius Waller ready. After Courtney leaves here, we're going to get him ready, and he shall go to college also and play college basketball.
Great. That's Linda and Finn Waller's son.
Yes.
And I taught Linda at Woodbury. So it's good that we've got you. You're grooming the young men to take the place of those who will graduate. How many seniors will you lose this year?
I have 6 seniors right now.
Gracious, I know you hate to see them go, but there's always some to step up and fill in their shoes.
And that's the good thing about being here in Manchester. You got young guys that can step up and take the place of those guys that are leaving. Demonstrated this year, we had 5 seniors to graduate last year. We had some to step in and have done a terrific job.
Good, good. When are the playoffs, Coach?
Playoffs going to start first week in February.
And we're pretty sure we'll be in at least the first round.
Yes, right now we are tied, three-way tie for first place. We have Tri-County, Pike County, and all sales tied for first place.
Good. And, of course, we'd like to say we're going all the way, but I know how you are. Take it one game at a time.
Yes, and our theme this year is to win it all. That's the state title.
Good. And I hope we do it, and I'll be there. The two state titles we have won, I've been there, and I want to be there for this one, too. So make it happen, Coach.
And we're working on it.
Good. Thank you for being with us today, and best of luck to you.
All right, thank you.
Uh-huh. We'll be back.
Hot with a jam. Vot with a rebound and
here we have Coach Noble and Kovatny together. For almost 60 years, F&M Bank and Trust Company has offered the citizens of this area full-service banking. Customers know they can depend on complete confidential financial service whether they visit our main office downtown or the Town and Country branch office on Warm Springs Highway. Today, F&M Bank is your only hometown bank. This means your money stays here, not only working for you, but for our community as well. We're always glad to be of service and are happy to call this fine community our home. F&M Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender. Thanks for watching our show today. I hope you enjoyed that, and we certainly expect great things from Vot and the Manchester Blue Devils. We'll be interviewing Coach Nobles later as we go into the playoffs, and of course he'll want to go into detail about all the players and what we expect in the playoffs. We wish them all the best of luck, and go all the way, guys. We'd love to bring home another state championship. Have a good week. Join us next time. Do something nice for somebody. God bless.
It's time for Channel 10's Valentine's Search 2005. Hi, I'm Brian Gibson, and Channel 10 wants you to write us a letter, one page or less, telling us why you feel your parents or a married couple in our area deserve to be our Valentine Couple 2005. Please include your name, the names of the couple, your phone number and theirs, and return address for both. Once we have all the letters at the end of the day, February 10th, 2005, the staff of Channel 10 will then select the most deserving couple and will be announced on Valentine's Day, February the 14th. The prize is valued at over $500. That includes two-night stay at the beautiful Callaway Inn, dinner for two at Magic City Grill, one dozen roses, balloons, and teddy bear from Dee Dee's Flowers, $100 gift certificate from Taylor Foster Gifts, $50 gift certificate from Nana's Porch, and a massage by Patty for both him and her. That couple you're thinking of could have a Valentine to remember. So act now and write us today. You can bring your letter to the studios of Channel 10 or mail it to us at 129 West Main Street, Manchester, Georgia, 31816. Again, deadline to enter is February 10th, 2005.